Hi everyone, how are you all? Wishing you all a very, very happy World Environment Day. I don't think so, there has ever been a moment in our life ever before where the importance of having a healthy environment around us has been understood by us like we are understanding it today. So it is evident to all of us now that having a healthy atmosphere and treating our environment with respect is of utmost importance for us to remain healthy in our life and to be able to lead our life longer, to have a longer healthy life and to leave a world for our younger generations, a world that will have enough space for them to have a long, healthy life as individuals, isn't it? So what is it that we can do, especially now when it has become an utmost necessity to take care of the planet Earth, for our environment, for our atmosphere, make it worry about it more than we have worried ever. So in this video of mine, I want to dedicate this entire video to Mother Earth and take little steps towards the betterment of our environment and towards the cleaning up of the entire system. What can be done? First of all, being a health coach, I would like to talk about nutrition. And I would like to say that, discuss that there will be this one particular trend that will definitely help us sail through these difficult times and bring us stronger once the wave has passed by. And that would be a wave of a trend of vegetarianism or veganism. I think people are now realizing how much damage to the mother nature has been done by the abuse the animals have gone through all these years, the ways they've been butchered and they've been made into processed foods in factories. There was a way when people back in the day, when people were finding ways of extinguishing their hunger through food. Some would go take fruits and vegetables, cook them and eat them. Some would go hunt animals, cook them and eat them. But there was a way of doing it, which completely due to all the, the profit-making companies and FMCG products, the convenience foods that came into the market. We can even buy meat canned in a box. How is that possible? So all that led to a lot of animal brutality and cruelty that happened. Previously, when people used to use cow's milk to nourish their children, for having more nutrition in their own body, they used to keep those cows in their homes and nurture them, take care of them. And there was a feeling of a lot of service towards that animal, towards that cow or a buffalo, which in turn would give them milk. And there is a quotient of happiness in that animal's life that used to also pass on to us, so that when we used to consume those products, so that that would make us healthier. But what has happened is we put those cows into factories for producing bulk volumes of milks for to satisfy our ever growing population, which has never been controlled ever. So much animal cruelty, so much. Why, when there are so many other foods that we can consume to remain healthy, to get calcium, to get protein, there is so much we can do it in our diet. Why did human being turn towards ways of having so much of brutality towards animals? I think that needs to stop. If we want to survive, if human race today wants to survive, and wants to leave a world for their coming generations that is gonna be disease-free, that is gonna have less infections and less viruses running around, that will have healthy food means for them to rely on for having a healthy life. This needs to stop, and it can easily be stopped. There is so many other ways of, you know, there are ways of turning into a vegan, or, you know, supporting vegetarian lifestyle, than to just completely all the time keep making your body dependent on animal food, animal products. So that is point one. Point two, I want to discuss packaging. You know, I know that the FMCG, the biggest market players all over the world, haven't listened to it yet. Everything still comes packed in plastics. Plastics that are disposable plastics. We have to open the packet and, you know, use the ingredient in our cooking in one day, and then leave that bag of plastic to rot around in our environment, in our earth, to adulterate our soil for millions of years. Is it really worth it? Weren't people in the old days, were they not able to go to an open market with a bag of their own, or a box of their own, or a container of their own, buy their produce and come back? That was also a way of living, and people were much more healthier, were much more mentally stronger at that time. Why can't we do the same? But, you know, no matter how much we try to do it, and no matter how much we want to do it, the problem is the convenience food industry has made such a culture already that you can't buy something that is not already wrapped in too much of plastic. You know, even there are places where you buy cold storage vegetables where each piece of the vegetable will be wrapped in a cling film. I don't get it. You know, as a human being, I find it ridiculous. And if they haven't been able to think of alternative ways of packing their food even till today, then when? Can we not come up with ways of, you know, carrying our own bag? Fine, we are doing that. But then the individual items that we pick up for buying are all wrapped in plastic. So, you know, things need to change. Mother Earth needs a change. And I think we all realize it now. There were people who would not believe in all this, where people who don't even believe in climate change, but I hope they don't do the same today. They have to accept responsibility and take action. And then comes the food that we cook ourselves, and let's say we have to wrap it up and give it to our child to eat at school, or, you know, wrap it up for ourselves. In India, we used to have nice steel tiffins previously. Can't we go back to those? Is it that important to have a Hello Kitty or a Peppa Pig or a Spider-Man on top of your tiffins for your little children? I have literally openly talked to my kids about it, that your tiffin is going to be a steel box, plain steel box. It will be very healthy for you and is sustainable for Mother Nature. And Mother Nature is, we are responsible to her. Mother Nature has provided us with so much that if we can't even do this in return for them. And you know what? My little children, 6-year-old, 9-year-old, agree with me. And they say, yes, we don't want any fancy tiffins. We are okay to take our simple tiffin, open in front, proudly in front of our kids, other classmates, and not feel ashamed about it. Let's do this, guys. We have to sit and talk to our children about the impact all this causes to our environment and what all we as individuals can do. Every small step can take us to the next and can heal our environment slowly and slowly. Let's do that. It's much needed in this hour, especially. So, leaving you all with two simple messages, let's take two small steps one by one. I'm not asking people to completely give up non-vegetarian food. I know it is part of many cultures and a lot of people can entirely depend on non-vegetarian food sources. But if we could opt for sources which are kind towards the animals, you know, farm-fed, grass-fed. When you're going for your meat, you should know in which condition it was, you know, it was prepared for you to make it edible for human consumption. It shouldn't be the way it has become. We have to be more responsible towards the animals. They are a part of this environment as well. Apart from that, the packaging of the food. If we can all take this very seriously, take this up very seriously, that all the food that we'll buy from the markets, we'll take it in our own packaging. We will, the FMCG companies have to come up with ways where they can wrap up foods, especially the dry ingredients can easily be packed up in, you know, non-plastic packaging. And it's definitely the need of the hour. Apart from that, you know, go for recipes that are seasonal. You know, whatever is being grown in your environment at that time in your local regions should be a part of your diet. How does that support your environment? Is by supporting the farmers who take care of your environment. It's by supporting the regional businesses, the small local businesses around you. And how does it support you? You'll be much healthier if you're eating seasonal local goods that are produced around you. So, you know, if we take care of the environment takes care of us in return. Apart from that, you know, whatever is being cooked using those seasonal products should be by environmental friendly ways of cooking. You know, it's not really all the time required to open up a barbecue to have a fancy party. No, we have to think of energy consumption and the amount of smoke the cooking process is generating. So there is so much, if you go deeper into all these processes, there is so much to look into and so much to think about while we are thinking about saving our environment. And I would say, let's just take this Environment Day as an excuse. And in the next 1 week, I'll be sharing, you know, delicious recipes on my IGTV Instagram handle. All the social media handles are mentioned in the description below. Please follow me. So I will be dedicating this next 1 week towards the World Environment Day, and I'll be sharing healthy recipes on my Instagram handle every single day. And the recipes that will guarantee you the taste of your favorite non-vegetarian food, but cooked with vegetables and non-animal products. So that's my promise on the World Environment Day. Do stay connected. If you like my video and if you'd like to stay connected with me, please subscribe to my channel, My22BMI Care. And like the video, comment below so that I can get in touch with you and get to know you better. And do share this video with your friends and family, to anyone you think would like to, you know, listen to the video like this. And do stay connected with me on my Instagram as well for all the delicious recipes that I'll be coming up with. So once again, a very, very happy World Environment Day to all of you. And thank you so much for supporting by subscribing to my channel and by being always there to listen to my videos. It's really a pleasure. And thanks. Thank you, guys.